one has been completed.
So classify
चलो
into capital expenditure and revenue expenditure.
हाँ, सो वेट, फर्स्ट थिंग इज कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर इज लाइक एक्सपेंडिचर दैट लाइक इज नॉट डन डेली, राइट?
Yes.
एंड रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर इज लाइक द एक्सपेंडिचर दैट इज डन ऑन अ डेली बेसिस. या ओके, सो बिल्डिंग न्यू एक्सटेंशन टू वेयर हाउस, दैट्स अ कैपिटल एक्सपेंडिचर दैट्स ऑलरेडी देयर. रेट्स ऑन न्यू एक्सटेंशन, व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय लाइक रेट्स ऑन न्यू एक्सटेंशन? लाइक यू नीड टू पे फॉर द रेट्स,
Yes,
सो इट्स अ रेवेन्यू, राइट?
but it is an extension, right?
या इट्स एक्सटेंशन, या
So,
रेवेन्यू.
revenue expenditure होता है, तो rates on
ओके,
new extension, rates recurring expense होता है. So, this is a
सो
revenue expenditure.
या आई वाज राइट.
Okay.
ओके,
Carriage costs.
रूफ टाइल्स फॉर
कैरिज
न्यू
कॉस्ट फॉर रूफ
स्ट्रक्चर
टाइल्स फॉर न्यू स्ट्रक्चर,
कैपिटल.
दैट्स कैपिटल
Why capital?
बिकॉज इट्स कैरिज कॉस्ट, यू जस्ट नीड टू फिक्स द रूफ.
Okay, so all expenses to buy the non-current asset up till using it for the first time will be added to the cost of the asset.
What do you mean by that? Like, I don't get
So
it.
basically, you have these roof tiles and you need to get these roof tiles to your warehouse to fix it. So this is added to the new extension cost, and if you're extending your building, it becomes a non-current asset. Okay. Legal cost for new extension.
लीगल कॉस्ट, मिस व्हाट इज लीगल कॉस्ट?
Legal cost, that means you're buying a building and you are extending the building. You're buying the building and you are extending the building. To extend this building, you had incurred some costs. And this cost is the legal cost.
यस,
Will it be a capital expenditure or a revenue expenditure?
इट्स अ कैपिटल बिकॉज़ यू जस्ट एक्सटेंडेड द बिल्डिंग.
So every expense that you incur from buy till use for the first time will be the capital expenditure. So legal cost for new extension will be capital expenditure. Repairs.
Repairs to
To
office
office
roof,
roof, capital.
capital.
Isn't repairs a maintenance cost? No,
you can't repair a roof like twice per month, right? So there's no point of revenue.
Revenue expenditure is all expenditure that you incur to maintain the asset in running condition.
Maintain. Okay, yeah. So yeah, this is a revenue then.
So
It's to
this is a
maintain.
revenue expenditure. Please keep in mind what is capital and what is revenue. That is why I was asking you all to see the revision videos again and again.
Miss,
That
I
helps
disagree.
me. So Jas's business is expanding rapidly and they need more warehousing space. Jas has an option that he can rent the warehouse, and if he takes the warehouse on rent, he would have to pay $40,000 for first 6 months. Okay? He has another alternative that he can buy the warehouse for 900,000. And if he buys the warehouse, he can take a long-term loan. He can take a loan for 700,000. You have to advise Jazz whether he should rent or purchase. Now it is for 5 months, so you have to give 2 points for renting the warehouse, 2 points for purchasing the warehouse, and 1 point for advice.
1 point for advice.
So tell
Okay,
what
so
will happen if Jack will rent the warehouse?
थोड़ी कोशिश कर रही थी.
What will happen if you rent the warehouse? What will happen if Jack
Okay,
rents a warehouse?
if Jazz rents a warehouse, okay, so he's like renting out to someone else, right?
No, he
Or he's
changes
purchasing.
the warehouse
Huh.
rent.
Okay. So first thing, the cost would be less
Okay, the
rather than
cost
just,
will be less.
yeah, the cost would be less rather than purchasing. And what else? He doesn't need to pay any a large amount of interest back
So
just for
that is
renting.
what you said, na? The cost will be less.
Yeah, but okay. Could you give
There
like
will
another point?
be little or no repair cost.
Why? How come?
If he is renting the warehouse, he's just going to use the warehouse. So whatever will be the repairs on the warehouse or whatever will be the maintenance of the warehouse,
Yeah. The owner would take care of it for.
Yes.
Okay.
So this is the good thing about renting the warehouse. If he is renting the warehouse, the cost will be less. There will be little or no repair cost. And the
Yeah.
rent can, but what will happen? The rent can increase after 6 months.
Yeah, the rent could increase after 6 months, which therefore could increase. Okay, yeah. Yeah,
Okay,
rent could
these are
increase
the
after.
things that you can talk about rent.
Okay.
Now,
Okay.
what you can talk about buying? If he buys the warehouse, he will have to
He
pay 200,000
will.
immediately. And he can take
Yeah.
a loan for 700,000. So you have to give some points for buying.
Okay.
What
So
points?
the first thing for buying is that he would have like all the access for the warehouse and nobody's in control. And
So if he buys the
he has
warehouse,
full access of the warehouse. He's
he
he
will
has
own
full access of the
the warehouse.
warehouse. Yeah, he will own the warehouse basically. But the main disadvantage is that the loan he took, like
He
the
will have to
percentage.
pay 200,000 immediately
Why 200,000?
because he
Why?
can take loan only for 700,000. Well,
Yeah. Okay.
this will lead to cash flow problem.
Yeah, this will lead to cash problem.
Cash flow problem.
Yeah, cash flow problem, yeah.
Interest will be high on the loan.
Yeah, the interest would be high on the loan, yeah.
Interest will be high on the loan. So what should Jazz
What should he do?
do?
Buy, sell
Rent.
a rent.
Keeping above in mind, it's better to take the
Yeah.
warehouse on rent. Write
Yes, miss.
Miss,
the answer.
if you rent it, will you have every accommodation?
Sorry?
Like, can you access everything or
Yeah,
no?
you can do everything that you want, but only if that you will have to pay $40,000 for 6 months. But if you want to buy the warehouse, you can only take loan of 700,000, 200,000 has to go immediately. And you have to advise him what is he supposed to do, whether he buy it or rent it. So you speak 2 points about renting, 2 points about buying, and then you can give an advice. Write the answer.
Okay.
Balance begin down was in the question, which is already given. This
Yes.
on the debit side of
Yeah.
the cash, this represents your cash in hand.
Yes.
And this bank on the credit side represents what? It
Cash
represents
in.
bank overdraft.
Okay.
What does this represent?
A bank overdraft.
Cash sales financing
Yeah.
directly in bank account.
Yes, okay.
So directly in the bank, money coming
Yes.
paid insurance 360.
Paid
Direct debit, that means money
insurance.
is going out of the bank.
Yeah. Yes.
Yes.
Credit side bank calling. Yeah.
Now this one is very important. Paid
Ninth, the GH limited.
196 to GX Limited by telephonic transfer. Telephone transfer. That means money is going out.
Yep.
Yes.
So credit side
How much?
having 196, but having deducted 2%
Which
cash
side?
discount. Credit side.
Your
How
side.
much is going out?
196.
196.
196 is after deducting 2% cash discount. So can you tell me how much is the amount for cash discount?
How much is the amount for cash before cash discount?
I want to know the amount of cash discount.
Okay, so four.
How did you get four? By stealing.
196 into 2% is equal to 3.92.
No.
So significant figure, so four.
Now look over here. What is the question telling? I have paid 196 after deducting 2% cash discount. So
Okay.
if I had to pay 100, if I had to pay 100, I will deduct 2% cash discount and then I will pay 98. Are you with me? I have paid 196 after deducting cash discount. That means this 196 represents 98.
Okay.
196 represents what?
198. 198.
So how much is 2?
196
Cross
plus
multiply.
2.
196 into 2 divided by 98. So how much is the cash discount?
Four.
4.
Okay.
Are you with me?
Yeah.
Paid 75 for stationery. Money is going out.
Credit.
Sold office equipment. Who paid 50 in full settlement?
It means there is a discount
Money
allowed.
coming in. But I don't know the amount of office equipment, right? And when I sell office equipment, I will write disposal. Now this one. Paid 340 to call in by check. How much did you pay?
340.
In
340.
settlement of how much?
350.
So what is the discount? 10.
Ten.
Please do
Okay.
the sum